Senator from Georgia.
Mr. President, I rise in strong support of the Graham Amendment, and I wish to echo the sentiments just expressed by my friend from Alabama, who, like me, has had extensive experience in trying cases for many, many years. In this country, over our 225-plus years, we've been involved in many different military conflicts. In each of those conflicts, dating back to the early years, there have always been prisoners captured, and we've always had a procedure whereby we incarcerated and ultimately tried those individuals who were captured on the battlefield. The process of how we operate from an Article III criminal standpoint relative to criminals in America who commit offenses against the United States of America is one thing. The process that we've always used to deal with those individuals that we capture on the battlefield has been entirely different, and all for the right reasons. I know there have been those that have gotten up here over the past several weeks and months. We've talked about this issue from time to time, and I've had any number of amendments on this and spoken on the floor numerous times about it. It's important, I think, for the protection and the security of the American people to keep all of these individuals that we captured on the battlefield who are incarcerated at Guantanamo outside of America. We've got the mechanics set up to try them. We've got a very safe place for them to be incarcerated. That's frankly where they ought to stay until some method can be worked out to deal with them, to have them housed somewhere outside of the United States. Unfortunately, the President's made a commitment to close Guantanamo by January 22nd without ever having a plan in place as to how he was going to deal with them. Here, what we're talking about doing is making sure that not all of those prisoners, because the folks on the other side of the aisle have already said, we want to bring the prisoners from Guantanamo to American soil. We want to try them there, and ultimately, I guess they're saying we want to house them in American prisons. I think that's wrong. This amendment, though, is even narrower than that, and that's why it's so important. This amendment says we're going to take the meanest of these individuals who get up every day seeking of ways to kill and harm Americans, and we want to make sure that they never come to American soil for trial and are never subjected to the process that is developed in Article III courts for average, ordinary criminals that are tried every single day in America. Khalid Sheikh Mohammed is the admitted mastermind of September 11. He is one of the individuals who today is housed at Guantanamo Bay. He is one of the individuals going to be directly affected by this amendment. Does Khalid Sheikh Mohammed want justice? No. Khalid Sheikh Mohammed wants a platform. He wants a platform on which to exude his arrogance and his hatred of America and his hatred of Americans, as exhibited by the plan he put in place to fly airplanes into the Pentagon, the World Trade Center, and another entity that was probably the United States Capitol. That airplane ultimately crashed in Pennsylvania. You know, there were over 3,000 victims on September the 11th. It's my understanding that family members of those victims have written letters and made phone calls urging the passage of this amendment. They are an indication of the strong feeling that prevails all across America relative to how we deal with these individuals who particularly intended and did, in fact, carry out an attack against America, an atrocious attack that took the lives of over 3,000 people. Mr. President, I commend Senator Graham for even thinking of the idea of narrowing this amendment to include just those individuals who participated in the September 11 attack. I would rather broaden it to include all of those who are housed at Guantanamo. And I defy anyone to stand up and say that trying any of those individuals who are housed at Guantanamo that were captured on the battlefield in an Article III court in the United States would be similar to some other terrorists that we've tried in this country. That is wrong. We have never tried anybody that was arrested on the battlefield in an Article III court in the United States. So Senator Graham's amendment is very appropriate. It ought to be passed. It ought to be passed with a large margin. And a vote against this is simply a vote to give Khalid Sheikh Mohammed that platform that he wants to have to talk about why he hates America and about everything that's wrong with America. That's not what we ought to be doing in this body today or at any other time. I urge a positive and affirmative vote on the Graham Amendment.